Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ. And a warm welcome to all of you joining us here. We are coming to you live from St. Peter's Square on this day, the solemnity of the Assumption, a day on which the Universal Church praises the Heavenly Father for the marvelous work he has accomplished in our Blessed Mother. And this is the solemnity on which we recall her Assumption, body and soul, into heaven. In just a few moments, Pope Francis will come to the window of the Apostolic Palace and provide us with a message, as well as lead the traditional Marian Angelus prayer. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to welcome all of you who are joining us today. I welcome you to this live broadcast. Some of you are joining us through the various Vatican media channels, perhaps the Vatican News live event app, the Radio Vaticana app, the Vatican News English web portal, YouTube channel, or our Facebook live feed. To all of you joining us through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Networks, Shalom World Television Networks USA, EWTN TV, Radio Maria England, Salt and Light Television, Shalom TV India, and Madarshan TV India, UCTV, Uganda Catholic TV, Luminous Radio India, and all of you joining us through radio stations, or all of you tuning in through other local or diocesan radio broadcasts, or those of you picking up the shortwave transmission, welcome to you all. We also welcome those joining us through our American Sign Language broadcast, and to all of you joining through other internet sites and digital platforms throughout the world. We welcome you and thank you for joining us. My name is Bonga Majola, and it is a pleasure to be able to provide you with the English language translation today. You might remember that last year on the same feast day, our Holy Father Pope Francis invited all of us, especially the pilgrims gathered here at St. Peter's Square, to consider visiting a Marian shrine today. It's a beautiful gesture to venerate the Madonna in particular. He suggested that they visit the Basilica of St. Mary Major, one of the oldest Marian shrines in the world, and the oldest in the West. And he encouraged us to pray before the icon of Our Lady, known as Salus Populi Romani. And we've all seen that icon. We see now the Pope is ready. We are going to prepare ourselves to listen to the words of the Holy Father. We join the crowds as they welcome him. Yes, there's a lot of people. Fratelli e sorelle. Buongiorno. Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno. Today, Solemnity of the Assumption of the Virgin Mary, we contemplate her ascending in body and soul to the glory of heaven. Today's Gospel also presents her to us as she ascends, this time into the hill country. She ascends to help her cousin Elizabeth, and there she proclaims the joyful canticle of the Magnificat. Mary ascends, and the Word of God reveals to us what characterizes her as she does so. What is the specific characteristic? Service to her neighbor and praise to God. Mary is the lady of service. Mary is the lady who praises God. The evangelist Luke, moreover, narrates the life of Jesus himself as an ascent upwards towards Jerusalem, the place of his self-giving on the cross, and he also describes Mary's journey in the same way. Jesus and Mary, in short, travel the same road, two lives that ascend upwards, glorifying God and serving brethren.
l'uomo che dà la vita per noi, per la nostra giustificazione. Maria come la serva che va a servire.
Two lives, that of Jesus and that of Mary.
Due vite che
vincono. These are two lives that conquer death and they rise again. Two lives whose secrets are service and praise. Let us look more closely at these two aspects, service and praise. Service, it is when we stoop to serve our brethren that we are elevated. It is love that elevates life. When we serve others, that's when we are elevated. But serving is not easy. Our Lady, who had just conceived, travels almost 150 kilometers to reach Nazareth, Elizabeth's house. Helping costs. We know this. In our lives, we experience this too, in fatigue, in patience and worries that taking care of others entails. Think for an example of the kilometers that many people travel every day to and from work, and the many tasks they perform for others. Think of the sacrifices of time and sleep in caring for a newborn or an elderly person, the effort in serving those who have nothing to offer in return, in the church and in voluntary work. I admire these people. It is tiring, but it is ascending upwards. It is reaching heaven. And this is true service. But service risks being sterile without praise to God. Indeed, when Mary enters the home of her cousin, she praises the Lord. She does not talk about her weariness from the journey, but rather a song of jubilation springs from her heart. Because those who love God know praise. And today's gospel shows us a cascade of praise. The child who leaps with joy in Elizabeth's womb, Elizabeth who utters words of blessing, and the first beatitude. Blessed is she who believed. Blessed is she who believed. And everything culminates in Mary who proclaims the Magnificat. Praise increases joy. Praise is like a ladder. It leads hearts upwards. Praise raises souls and defeats the temptation to give up. Have you seen that bored people, those who just go around gossiping, they are incapable of praising God? Ask yourselves, myself, am I capable of praising God? How good it is to praise God every day, and others too. How good it is to live in gratitude and blessing instead of regrets and complaints, to raise our gaze upwards instead of keeping a long face. There are people who are always complaining. I mean, look, God is so close to you. God speaks to you. Look at the things that God has given to you. Praise. Start praising God. And this is healthy. This is a healthy spirituality. Service and praise. Let us ask ourselves, do I live my work and daily occupations with a spirit of service? Do I devote myself to someone freely without seeking immediate advantages? In short, do I make service the springboard of my life? And thinking about praise, do I, like Mary, exult in God? Do I pray in blessing the Lord? And after praising Him, do I spread His joy among the people I meet? Each one of us, let's try and respond to these questions.
La nostra madre assunta in cielo ci aiuti a salire ogni giorno.
May our Mother assumed into heaven help us to climb higher each day through service and praise.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus. E benedetto frutto ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitat in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Digni efficiamus provisionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut qui angelo nunciante, Christi fili tui, incarnazione coniovi, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Santo.
Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Santo.
Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Santo.
Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine,
et lux perpetua luce a teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terra.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle,
my dear brothers and sisters, I greet all of you present here, pilgrims from Rome and from different countries. In a particular way, I greet young people from the Diocese of Verona. I wish you a beautiful experience here in Rome, your summer experience here in Rome. And today we entrust the prayer for peace in Ukraine to the Immaculate Heart of Our Mary, but also different regions that are tortured by war. Unfortunately, there are so many. And of course, the continuing arms, they prevent us from entering into dialogue. But let us not be discouraged. Let us continue hoping and praying that God, because God is the one who is leading us and who is the head of the story, of history. And today, the day of Our Lady, I greet the young people of the Immaculate. I wish you all a happy feast, and please, don't forget to pray for me.
Buon pranzo e arrivederci.
And there we are, buon pranzo e arrivederci, signs out Pope Francis after this beautiful prayer and a beautiful reflection on the Angelus prayer for the solemnity of Our Lady assumed into heaven. And of course, this then brings to the close, this ends the live broadcast of the recitation of this Angelus on the solemnity of Our Lady assumed into heaven. Please visit the Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's Angelus and other Vatican and world news. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to also thank our in-studio audio technicians and our audio coordinator and all our media partners, TV and radio, and our friends who have joined us today. My name is Bonga Majola. It's been a great pleasure to provide this live translation in English. May God bless you. We wish you all a happy feast day, and may Our Lady assumed into heaven continue to intercede and pray for us all. Arrivederci.